This will be a quick video on Wan 2.2, an improved version of Wan 2.1. And this is the 14 billion parameter model. The release also included a smaller 5 billion FP16 model that works on smaller graphic cards. In this video, I plan to show the 5 billion original and the GGUF models, but then while making this video, I added the 14 billion GGUF workflow as well, which should work on an 8GB card. So before we proceed to the workflow, make sure to update the program using this update batch file. Inside the comfyUI manager, get these comfyUI GGUF nodes. Make sure you have the GGUF node updated if you already had in your comfyUI. This is the simple workflow I am using to run the smaller 5 billion FP16 model. This image to video was generated on my 4060 Ti 16GB card, and the time it took was around 450 seconds. The people in the background are blurred, but the unnatural blending with surrounding elements has been reduced. An issue I often saw in the previous AI-generated videos on similarly sized models. I generated a video with a 5 billion Q3 GGUF model, but the iteration time and usage may not make sense when you look at this program's output on my screen. Throughout the test, the iteration time was around 38 and increased slightly based on the size of the model I selected. The file size of the Q3 model is around 3 GB, but somehow my system usage looks too high. But I'm sure this should work on smaller cards. The result of the Q3 model is flickering as expected, and some black smoke appeared in the last frame. Next, I tried the Q4 model. The time taken for one step is similar to the Q3 model. And after 490 seconds, I got the result, which is not perfect. These smaller models may give you good result, but only after multiple attempts. These are the 5 billion parameter GGUF models, which I was supposed to show you at the beginning of the video. I will download the Q5, Q6, and Q8 models from here, save them inside the models, and then in the UNet folder. The 5 billion FP16 model I used at the beginning of the videos was saved in the diffusion model folder. This is the 14 billion model, which also goes in the same folder, but it takes around 22 gigabytes of memory. This model also needs a different workflow. I am still about to test this and the 14 billion GGUF models for a low VRAM card while I am recording this video. Links to the T5 clip and the VAE will be given in the description. The T5 will be in the text encoder folder, and this VAE will be in the VAE folder. I tried the Q5 model. It took around 500 seconds, and this is the result. It is a 4 GB model, and there are some moving artifacts on the top. Next is the Q6 model with a file size of around 4.2 GB. This model can be recommended for a smaller card under 8 GB. In this video, there is a red glow on his right hand. The rest looks good. I then tried the Q8 model, which is just above 5 GB in size, and the result is fine. The movement looks fast, but what else can we expect from a 5 GB model? There is this small Q2 model, which is even smaller than 2 GB, and I do not know why they bother keeping a Q2 model. I tried the model, and even this model was able to fill up around 15 GB in the VRAM. If anyone knows why this is happening, please let me know in the comments, or maybe I will have to keep a debugger and check the code. The result isn't surprising. The model has limited information, so a poor outcome is expected. I tested multiple videos using the 5 billion FP16 model, and roughly 1 in 3 results turned out well. For the rest, you'll need to tweak your prompts based on the quality of the output. I tried generating a few 16 FPS videos with 121 frames, but the results weren't great. The video length can be adjusted from here. At 24 frames per second, 121 frames give you about 5 seconds of video. You can increase the length if needed, but keep in mind that it starts using a lot more memory. If you have a smaller graphic card, the only model that can be recommended is the Q6 and Q8 GGUF. And if you have 8GB card, then definitely the 5 billion FP16 model. It is larger, but it may work. Please mention if it worked in the comments. Make sure you have this FP8 selected here, or else FP16 will take around 14 minutes to give out the result. So instead of winding up the video, I continued and tried the 14 billion GGUF model, which is significantly better. This workflow can be found here as well, inside the video. I used this workflow, but the template won't work straight away. There are changes. In this workflow, there are two case samplers. This GGUF model and the LoRa all goes to this case sampler. Similarly, this model and LoRa also goes to this case sampler. Now, I will not go into much technicality. With the help of a prompt and an image, this case sampler generates video using the high noise model. Once done, it gives an output which is usually decoded by the VAE decoder. However, now the same is processed again by the second case sampler with the help of a low noise model. More details are added in the video, and the final result becomes better than what we saw in the previous in the Wan 2.1 workflow. I think I should try using this low noise model in the older Wan 2.1 workflow and process the video twice with two case samplers. Maybe I can get something better in the older workflow as well. Also, the VAE used here for encoding and decoding is the same as we used in the older Wan 2.1 workflow. This resize image node can be removed if you have a bigger graphics card. I have removed the node, and my video generation will now become extremely slow. Based on the image, I have added the width and height for the video and queued the workflow. This is super slow. One step took 222 seconds. That was my total video generation time. I tried canceling the process, but it did not stop. I then closed the program's output. I have added the resize node again. I checked if it is working before adding this workflow to the video's description. The 29 seconds for a step looks fine, and that is the best we can get in this simple setup, which is without Sage Attention. I think I should make a video on Windows Triton and Sage Attention setup, which will speed up the video generation. After restarting, the video took a bit longer to generate, and it looks fine. Now, let me show you the files I used in this video. This text file will be shared in the description. The original 5 billion FP16 models was used here. And the 5 billion GGUF model goes here. The clip file is the same for both workflows. And then this VAE is specifically for the original 5 billion and the 5 billion GGUF models. Now, let's look at the 14 billion model workflow. The 14 billion GGUF model goes here. Make sure to keep the high and the low noise model in the correct node as shown here. The clip is the same for both workflows. This VAE is the same as we used in the older 2.1 version. And the last is this LoRa. The same LoRa is used in both the nodes. These are the nodes installed. This is not in use. This can be used in video generation, but I have not used it. The rest are the common nodes you might be having already. Nothing special added in the workflow. This video was so unprepared, and nothing was organized because I was busy. I hope the video was simple and helpful.